Today on the Young and Free St. Louis Show, tips for making a great application video and a new Facebook contest. Welcome to the Young and Free St. Louis Show, the show that keeps you in the know about events and contests and brings you all the financial info you need to stay young and free. I'm your host and spokesperson, Rob Cartwright. Well, real quick, I'd like to tell you guys about a brand new Facebook contest we have coming up. This one's really easy. This coming Saturday, June 25th, the Young and Free St. Louis crew is going to be at Six Flags St. Louis. We're going to be over by the Batman coaster, and the Young and Free cube will be there. All you got to do is head on over there, take a picture of yourself in front of the cube, post it to our Facebook page at facebook.com/YoungFreeSt.Louis, and you are entered in a drawing to win a $50 Visa gift card. Now onto the good stuff. Well, if you've been following me at all, you know my time as spokesperson is almost up, and that means we're searching for the new voice of Young and Free St. Louis. And today I want to give you some tips that will help you make a great application video, so let's jump right in. The number one tip that I can give you that far exceeds any other tip you'll hear from me is to be yourself. We want to see your strengths and how you can use them to be a great spokesperson. For example, this job requires you to speak a lot. On almost a daily basis, you're going to be out around the St. Louis area talking to people our age. So if you can show us that you have the personality and the charisma to do that, your chances are that much better. The rest of my tips mainly involve the video itself, so let's start with the camera. Someone once told me that the best camera for whatever situation you're in is whatever camera you're currently holding. I shot my entire application video last year using this simple Canon point-and-shoot camera that just so happens to shoot video. Anything is better than no video at all, so don't get too caught up in picture quality. Lighting is another great way to make your video really stand out. If you're gonna shoot indoors, make sure you're well lit. I recommend grabbing a couple lamps, taking the shades off, and positioning them in front of you. You can also turn on an overhead light and sit just in front of where the light is projecting downward, and this will help separate you from your background. Shooting your video outdoors can make lighting even easier because natural sunlight is a great start. Try to position yourself in a location that's not too shaded, but is also not so bright that you're squinting through the whole video. The next thing you need to think about is audio. If you're shooting outdoors, pay close attention to the noise going on around you. What might sound insignificant to you might sound very loud coming through the camera's microphone. For example, wind. What might sound like a slight breeze to you might sound like a hurricane when you watch the video later. Now I want to talk a little bit about post-production. Now this is by no means necessary, but instead of uploading your video straight from your camera to YouTube, you can give it a little bit of pizzazz by using some free editing software. If you're using a Windows PC, you should have a free program called Windows Movie Maker. Likewise, if you're on a Mac, you have iMovie. Both of these programs should allow you to adjust the levels and settings of your video and do any editing that you need to. For example, if you shot your video outdoors, you might not have realized it while you're filming it, but a lot of inexpensive video cameras have a hard time dealing with very bright situations. So when you go back to look at your video, you might realize that you and your surroundings are so bright that the video looks bleached. A good start to fixing this is to open up your brightness and contrast levels, lower your brightness level, and raise your contrast level just a little bit. This is by no means a professional fix, but it's a good start, and it could keep you from having to reshoot your video. Adding music is another way to take your video to the next level. As a Young and Free spokesperson, you'll be putting music in all of your weekly videos, so now's a good time to start. But if you do add music, make sure that it's not copyrighted. You can find everything that you need by doing a quick Google search for royalty-free music, or you can take it one step further and ask a local St. Louis band if you can use their music in your video. And last but not least, when you're finished and ready to go, make sure you export it as a file that is compatible with YouTube. And that about wraps up this episode. I can't wait to see your application videos. Remember that the application deadline is July 11th, so now is the time to start filming. And as always, you can check us out on Facebook and on Twitter. Until next time, this is Rob, signing off.